Hello, and welcome to part 3 of Libelive. And in this part, we're gonna see a mouse, and the robot's gonna go insane! Oh no, watch out, guys! The robot's coming towards you!
Strike!
Did the robot just explode in front of a bunch of Kamoso monks?
And he's dead!
A robot buddy's dead?
Yep. He exploded.
I'm sad now.
If only we got another companion to make up for the fact that a robot's coming. Oh shit, that guy's a gun!
It won't be... Oh, well, if we get a new companion, it won't be the same.
Yeah.
Who are you? Who's here?
Is it someone else?
Who?
Whoa. It's a guy. And he also has a gun!
Oh shit!
What kind of ninja?
Would you believe that some ninja actually did actually use rifles as snipers?
It's Ryoma.
Yeah.
His name is Ryoma.
I mean, didn't Oda Nobunaga have one?
I'm fairly certain he did, or he was almost shot by one. One or the other. I don't know my ninja history as well
also,
as you think I do.
This guy's calling the spirit of Miyamoto.
Small ghost.
I mean, at least Ode Nobunaga in the Fate series carries guns.
Well, I know Nobunaga loved guns, because goddamn, they're useful, especially in the feudal Japan.
Yeah.
Wasn't there an anime called Nobunagan?
Nobunaga.
I saw that. Well, let's talk to the gun.
Why,
it's busted.
Why would a robot get mice?
I don't know.
It's a robot.
Anyway, let's talk to Musashi.
Huh. How about you? Oh, Jesus.
Yes, there is an anime called Nobunaga.
Oh, god damn it.
Anyway, let's look at Ryoma's moves. He's got Quick Draw Wolf Fang, which does a lot of damage.
Bishop Moneygill Pass.
Wait, Wolf Fang? Wolf Fang Fist.
Got one warning shot.
Oh, shit.
Ton of damage that it's got.
Wow. With Nobunaga, the manga went from 2011 to 2015, and the anime series was January 2014 to March 2014.
Oh.
Wait, that was Miyamoto Musashi.
Oh, he's just dead now, he is, again.
Back to the grave with you.
That's another going reason. To come up later, isn't it?
Yeah.
Absolutely
not. Oh,
who's
here now? Who?
It's some lady.
Oh my.
So be careful with this fight, because she can make you drunk.
Wait, isn't that the... Wait a minute.
Woohoo!
Is that fucking Maya? What her fucking name is from Asinkaya?
What?
My Hiranui.
I don't think so.
She's wearing red and her tits are out.
Oh no, Ryoma, watch out! Now he's drunk!
Yeah, drunk. No, he's not drunk. He's distracted.
Oh, wow. You could have tortured and she died.
Right on!
So you can encounter that woman earlier, and she will be added to the death count, but after you fight her here, she'll be subtracted. Anyways, this woman shows up, and she specifically shows up if you don't kill any woman in the castle.
Hmm.
She gives you some.
Was that Meki or was that? Oh.
The maid's Obi.
Huh.
Is it a good quit?
And, I'm going around because I'm confused about something, but I'll be a subject for, what a waiter in the video. Oh, good lord. Ugh.
Tigus!
Take that!
And that!
Bye, Ryoma.
Yoja and Satsuken. God damn, that's a mouthful.
He's still a life seal, and a little still as we did.
Yeah. Doesn't matter, though.
Oh, fucking hell, he's instant he is.
Spare
you really did level grind, goddamn.
He's so one level and died instantly for it.
he's like, it's like, I'm part of it is that I am overleveled, but he's also not a very strong boss intentionally. That was only his first form.
Oh god damn it! He's gonna, this is a square game.
He's ready for a jump cut because I forgot how to get something. So what you're supposed to do after the girl gives you the maid's obi, I assume, is look at the item, or at least equip it. I'm sitting here because I'm trying to think of what I could do. And I think, oh, let's equip it, see what happens. Then she'll instead give you the item she meant to give you.
Medical box.
The medicine box.
Can I still keep the other item? Yep. Yes, then you get.
Yep.
You do keep the other item.
Anyway. Sweet.
On to the end of the chapter. We're gonna duke it out on top of the roof.
Oh,
a climactic Japanese film ending.
Indeed.
On the roof.
I would feel more confident if we had our robot buddy with us.
Unfortunately, the robot buddy cannot be taken here. So, here's our strategy. He's the frog snake.
What kind of craziest anime are we watching?
I don't know.
Square.
So, our strategy is that Noel is going to sit in the corner and Ryoma's going to body block the demon.
With a demon, the ninja makes up the demon stuff. Was he always this demon?
Yeah, he was always this demon. His true form.
And no one knew about this.
Nope.
It's called ninja magic.
Good ninja then. Power down.
Ninja magic, demon magic, yokai magic. It's magic.
Oof.
And as we all know, magic must defeat magic.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm personally surprised that Ryoma managed to live, but hey, good for me.
Do you think Uncle would get the willies from this, David?
Karu certainly would.
Yeah, you're right.
More con downer.
So, fun fact here. You can recruit Ryoma earlier, but you gotta kill his guard to do so, I believe. Actually, no. You don't have to kill his guard. The thing about not recruiting Ryoma is that it does lock you out of the no-kill ending, because you have to kill those guys that were in Ode's room earlier. As if you don't recruit him, he gets rid of them for you. You know, they're scared of guns.
Mm. Rightfully so.
He's dead.
Although with the giant frog demon.
Right on.
Farewell.
I hear right on my first...
I like this song.
I hear right on my first reverse foot is looking Russian is. Oh. Oh, he dead.
What?
No, he's already dead, though, so...
Bye, Felicia. Now you have to fight Ryoma.
No, for killing nobody, we get Ryoma's sword, which I found out is actually kind of redundant if you fight Ryunosuke in the same run, because it has the exact same attack power.
Oh.
What?
You found the wall below. Oh, it's a boat.
Where the fuck that come from?
It's the Dutch.
From the sea.
The Dutch. You know, that's probably the best answer I can only get.
Yeah, it's the Dutch. With a spicy...
And he's about to tell us his full name. This is... Ryoma Sakamoto. You know, that one guy,
Is he related to Trevor?
Unfortunately not.
What about Ryuji?
I don't know. So, he's going to offer us to join him.
Join me, I'll make your face the greatest in all of Nippon.
Interesting.
Or you will Nippon.
Is there a difference between if you pick something? But what's the...
There is a difference, but it's very obscure, and I'll talk about it when we get there.
Oh, the sun coming. One thing that was flashing with the sun coming up.
In fact, the biggest difference is in the ending credits.
Okay.
Not these endings.
The actual ending game.
Yeah. This is ninja, this was.
The ninja chapter.
That was really short.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be longer, but I guess not.
Come on, guys. Come on, guys. The Dutch are waiting.
Well, that was a good move, everyone.
It's only the first chapter. What the fuck is now let me show you some events that I didn't go through.
Okay.
Oh, God, how many people died down here?
Why?
Hey, no, welcome to CZ knowing that he didn't do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I skipped it like a true ninja.
Monster art, battle background art, SFX art.
Sound effects.
It could be sound or special effects, because how the hot fuck do you make sound as art? In the 90s, mind you.
Main program. Battle program. Oh no, so you could have gotten Ryoma and fighting in
the Yeah, I was saying earlier that you could get Ryoma, but I chose not to.
I wasn't sure how early you meant by that.
Oh no, because you can... Because the thing for Ryoma escaping the cell on his own is defeating Genai. You gotta get him first and then fight Genai. But, you know, chose not to. Hey. Here's the scene where he summoned Musashi again. Oh well.
Who's the Ben translation?
That's a Japanese dialogue.
Okay.
Nomura. Oh.
And the Dutch. The best credit here.
Also, here we go. Music composer. Hey, Yoko. Yoko Shimomura.
Huh. That's why it sounded so good.
Yeah.
She makes gold out of anything.
Yeah, I remember that. I read that before that she did help on this.
I wonder, what were the worst games she's worked on, which has great soundtrack, but the game is shit, though, I'm wondering.
The original Street Fighter 2.
Yeah.
Speaking of Street Fighter 2,
next part, we're gonna go play some Street Fighter 2.
After killing zero people.
Yeah, we killed nobody. Nobody human, anyway.
At least nobody of worth.
Yeah, no one human.
Did that mean Finn?
Yeah, no one human. We're fine.
Yeah, which means that this ninja ever went to Undertale. What kill count? Nobody's human down here.
That is true. That is true. Kill count being zero.
I mean, heck, you're being killed because you are human.
Yeah, exactly. So really. Anyone's fair game in the underground for the ninja. Because the only kinds of human killing. I think that's non-human. Fair game.
In fact, if he finds out later that a person he killed wasn't human, he subtracts it.
Yeah. So that guy I killed earlier, who like your foggy was, great. I can put all the conscious I can. Okay, still perfect zero.